self-love is really taking care of yourself, giving yourself a break sometimes and motivating yourself and wanting to be more for yourself and then others. I have always been very happy about having a curvaceous body. I've never really given too much importance to having the perfect it body till the time I don't want to do something right. I think I'm someone who's sensitive, traditional in certain ways, but at the same point in time, pretty forward thinking. Also, a revolt in some ways. By the time I was turning 17, 18, I was always a little tall as compared to the generic norm of height. And so many of my mother's friends or relatives would come and say, oh, she should be an actor, she should be a model. More than an actor, model was the thing that they're modeling to me. But, and me coming from a typical Maru family, we would just shy away at that. Like my mother would be like, of course not. And I'll be like, of course not, because that is just something other people do. You know, how can you ever accept that any part of you wants to be one? I'm dusky. And I have always been very happy about being dusky, like right from the time I was a kid. And that time, though, the gorapan thing was pretty much very, like, prominent, right? So my friends would tell me, oh, you're looking fair today, and that would scare me. Like, I was like, no, I can't be fair. Like, I'm very happy with my duskiness. So if someone calls me dusky, in my head, that becomes a compliment immediately rather than anything else. So I've never thought of it that way, that, oh, why are they labeling this? Nobody would say a fair actor, right? Like this fair lady who's an actor. They don't say that, or this white actor, they don't say that. But they say that dusky actor, whatever. But I have always enjoyed it. I enjoy duskiness. I enjoy dark skin tones. I enjoy tan skin. I think it's not just very important to fight these labels. It is important to call them out for what they are. But most important is to be happy within yourself. And once you are comfortable, no one else can shake that about you. At least my parents and I, we've always been in a space where looks have been important, but it's been important to take care of what you have and to present that in the best possible manner, rather than being too worried about how fat you are, how slim you are, how you look all the time. For a woman, being beautiful is all about radiating, you know, when you radiate from within. And because we as women, I feel, are so blessed with who we are, right? We have so much within ourselves, like so many emotions. We are so blessed with so many characteristics. We can hold so much, we can give so much, we can be vicious and selfish at the same time, being nurturing and, you know, be jealous, but also be so caring and giving, and we are great multitaskers. We have so many emotions to deal with and to, you know, to offer. So I think when you just realize the umpteen amount of treasure that you have and hold within, and how you want to hone it and, you know, keep growing and keep adding on to that, I think that's when you are the most beautiful and you feel most beautiful.